Hello my dear students, good afternoon all of you. This is Tazib sir from Mahdi English Medium School. Today we are going to learn a new chapter, my dear students. So today we are starting a new chapter, chapter number 6, more division. So students, today we are starting here new chapter, but before starting our new chapter, let's check here today's code and then after we check today's content. So let's check here today's code. So perform like you were never lost. Perform like you were never lost means we have to perform like we are never lost. Like you were never lost. Okay, then now students, here we check today's content means today these things we are going to learn. Okay, my dear students, today these things we are going to learn. So students, today we are starting here the chapter number 6. Chapter number 6. What's the name of the chapter number 6? Chapter number 6, more division. Okay, we have done the division only, but here we going to learn a more division. Exploring division further. Okay, now in this chapter we are going to this type of topic. Exploring a division further, long division, remainder in division means remainder, left remainder in the division. In chapter number 6 students, a long division now means more division means 2-digit, 3-digit division. Understood my dear students? So first topic is exploring division further, then after the one next topic is the exploring division further and a long division, remainder in division, then exercise number 6e, a question number 1, solve using a short division. Got my point, my dear students? So these all things today we are going to learn. So now let's check here one by one all things. Here we only starting the chapter number 6, more division. So let's check here the chapter number 6, more division, and its topic is, I hope you all are remember what things are coming in the division. Okay, so here first topic is the exploring a division further, short division. What my dear students? Short division. Example number one, it's basis on a short division. So let's check here my dear students, since 4 multiplied by 2 means 4 2 is 8. Okay, before starting anything here my dear students, you have to must be compulsory mandatory learn the tables. Without table you don't do anything here. So it's my humble request to you my dear students, compulsory you learn the all things, learn the table, short division, okay, and tables you must be learn, huh, my dear students. Okay, so here we start the example number 1, 8 divided by 4. 8 divided by 4 means what to do, what we are checking here, we are checking here in table number 4, 8 will become or not. So students, pick here the table number 4. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, and now you tell me 4 twos are 8. So you tell me 4 twos are 8, so answer is what? 2. So 8 divided by 4 is equal to 2. 2 is what my dear students? What we are called 2? 2 is our quotient. What dear students? 2 is our quotient. So this can also be written as follows. How can we written a short division? See here, in a division we are make a box as like that upper side, but here we side a that side box. Okay, divisor is also its place of the divisor, divided place of it's a divided, and quotient, quotient is above than divided, but now is a lower than a divided, means a downside to divided. Okay, in a division a long we are right to a quotient in above the divided, and now a short division we are right in the means above means lower. Okay, downside the divided digit. Got my point? This is called a short division. This is called a what my dear students? This is called a short division. But we are follow that method. Okay, always we make the box upper side and answer right the above the divided quotient. Understood, my dear students? Now let's check your students example number 2. But don't forget to that word. Okay, that word you have to keep it in mind. Divisor, divided, and quotient. What, my dear students? Divisor, divided, and quotient. That all words keep it in mind. Understood, my dear students? Now example number 2. Okay, 18 divided by 6, 18 divided by how many, my dear students? 6. 18 divided by 6 means in table number 6, 18 will be come or not, dear students? In table number 6, 18 will be come or not? So now we speak the table number 6. 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, and 6 threes are 80. So where we reach 6 3s are 18. So here is 3. 3 is what, my dear students? Answer. Okay. 6 3s are 80. As like that we do. And here example number 3. 28 divided by 2. Means in table number 2, 28 will be come or not, my dear students? So let's check. 28. 2 10s are 20. So 28 is up to 20. So here we take the less than to 20. So first of all, 2 ones are 2. Okay, so we write the answer is what? 1. Then after we take the 8 is left. Okay, so 14. So okay, means 8. We bring it down 8 here. Okay, so 2 4s are 8. So is a make that number. So quotient is what? 40. Quotient is what, my dear students? 14. Okay, 28 divided by 2 is equal to 40. 28 divided by 2 is equal to means is a 40. Understood, dear students? So let's check here further. Here a short, here is which method we have learned? Short division. And now we further move on the long division. Which method we are going to apply here? Here we are going to apply a long division. Example number 1. 8 students. How many students are there, dear students? 8 students. 8 students work in pairs. So here example of the long division. 8 students work in the pairs helping the nursery class children with their art activity. What, dear students? Example number 1. 8 students work in the pairs. Means here 8 students are a work in a pairs. Okay, a pairs helping the nursery class. They all are helping to the nursery class children with their art activity. Which activity they are helping them? Art activity to help to the nursery class children. Okay, children. So how many pairs of students means, my dear students, how many, what is the question? Actually, here is that question. How many pairs of the students were there? Means here we have to find the how many pairs of students. How many total, how many students are there? Total 8 students are there. So see here the box. 8 students put into the group of 2 gives a 4 groups. Okay, 8 students put into groups of the 2 means we have to make a 2 groups. So 4 into 4, 4 plus 4, how many? 8. So we make only 2 groups. So in each group has a 4 students, as like that. Okay, so 8 divided by 2 means 2 4s are 8. So answer is what? 4. Answer is what, my dear students? 4. This can also be written like this. Okay, we have to written like this always. Okay, we have to return like this always. We are written like that. So my dear students, now we see the further. Okay, so quotient is what? That, see, quotient is what, dear students? Quotient is a 4. Okay, so let's take here, quotient is a 4, divisor is a 2, divided is 8. In red in color it's our divisor, green in color is our divided, and blue in color is our quotient, my dear students. So 8 is what? Our divided digit. Red in color, see, is our divisor. See, red in color all is divisor. Okay, and blue in color, it's called a quotient. Okay, so answer is what? There are 4 pairs of the students helping a nursery children in the there are activity. Each group has how many students? 2. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. And 6 plus 2 is equal to how many, my dear students? 8. Means there are 4 groups. 4 groups of students, and each group has 2 students. Okay, so there are 4 pair of students helping a pair means how many? Pair means 2. Okay, so there are 4 pairs. 4 pairs means 4 twos are 8, as like that. 4 twos are 8. So there are 4 pairs of students helping a nursery children in their art activity. Understood, dear students? Okay, so now we move on the further. Further is second example of long division. Okay, second example of long division. So let's check here, my dear student, the second example of long division. There are 42 children. Sorry, there are 42 children in the nursery class. How many children are in nursery class? 42 children in a nursery class. They are seated in equal group, equal groups around 6 tables. What, dear students? There are 42 children in the nursery class. Okay, so they are seated into equal groups groups around 6 tables. So how many children on each table? So we have to find how many children are seated on each table. Okay, that is means that is a long division, and this is called a long division. Okay, so 42 divided by 6. What, dear students? 42 divided by 6 means what to do? What we are checking here? Here we are checking in table number 6. 42 will become or not, my dear students? So say or speak. Think 6 times means table number 6. What a number gives a 42? So 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 6 threes are 80, 6 fours are 24, 6 fives are 30, and 6 sixes are 36, and 6 sevens are 42. So where we did 6 sevens are 42. So we have a right as like that here. 6 sevens are 42. So 42 minus 42 is equal to 0. But our quotient is what? 7. Okay, see here. 6 sevens are 42. Okay. 6 sevens are 42, dear students. Okay, so 6 sevens are 42. So there are 7 children around each table in nursery class. Okay, one table has a total 7 children around the tables. Okay, in nursery class, each table around the 7 children. How many children tables around 7 children around each table in nursery class. Understood, dear students? Now we move on the further. Reminder means reminder in division. Reminder in a division. So what to do, dear students? Reminder in division means example number 1. Ashish was packing 30 blankets for the distribution during a winter. Means Ashwin, it's the name of boy. He was packing 30 blankets. How many blankets? 13 blankets for a distributions during a winter. In a winter season, Ashwin was packing 30 blankets for a distribution. He was putting 4 blankets in one packet. Means how many packets he make? Okay, so question is what, my dear students? He was putting 4 blankets in one packet, and there are how many blankets? 30 blankets. So see here the diagram, here the figure draw, here pictures. Okay, here a picture. See all students the pictures of the blanket. See the one group. Okay, means one packet. In one packet is how many blankets? 4. 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus this one is 13. So one is left, it is not coming properly. We are not share equally 30 into the 4. So there are 3 groups of the 4 into 30. There is one blanket left over there. See, 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 1, 30. So we are not equally share a 30 blanket into the one packet equally 4 blankets in a one packet. So 4, 4, 4. So one group has a 5 coming, but one is a left, one is our reminder. What dear students? One is our reminder. So that point keep it in our mind, dear students. What? That point keep it in our mind, my dear students. So dear students, here example of blanket. There are three groups of the 4 in 13. There is a one blanket left over there. So let's check here. Okay, there are three groups of the 4 in 13. There is a one blanket left over there. Understood? There is a one blanket left over there. Sometimes in a division, we are many not be able to equal a group or equally share all the objects. Okay, sometimes might be a left over there. It means what, my dear students? You have any fixes number, means you have a 30, means sorry, you have to 29. So you are share equally? No, you are not share equally, means even number you are not share equally, means I am telling you, you make equal groups of 3. Okay, so how can you make a equal group? 1, 1, it's a make a 2 group, but 1 is left over there. Okay, otherwise I am telling you, my dear students, 7, you make a 2, 2, 2, 6. Okay, but you 1 is left over there, so you not make a properly group. You are not able to equal group or equally share to all. So that's why sometimes might be a left over there, dear students. Okay, so number that is a left over, okay, that number left over in a division, it's called a reminder. Reminder words is coming in new for you, dear students. Reminder words is coming from you new. Okay, the number that is a left over in the division, it's called the reminder. What, dear students? What, my dear students? Okay, so again I repeat, dear students, the number that is a left over in a division, it's called the reminder. The reminder will always be a smaller than the division. That is an important sentence. Keep it in mind and always we are reminder that sentence. The reminder will always be a smaller than the divisor. What, dear students? The reminder will always be a smaller than the division. Means a reminder is always a less than 2 our divisor. Got my point, dear students? Number in each group. Number in each group divisor. Okay, here a 30. 30 is what? Blanket. And how many groups? 4. Okay, so 4 threes are 12. So 30 minus 12. Okay, 30 minus 12. So how many? 1. Okay, so 1 is what, my dear students? Our reminder. Number left over there. 4 threes are 12. Number in all divided. And number of group is in a bluish color, is called a quotient. 30 is what, dear students? Divided. 4 is divisor. 3 is quotient. And 1 is, dear what, my dear students? 1 is what? 1 is reminder. Again I repeat, dear students, there are 3 groups of 4 in 30. There is a 1 blanket left over. Sometimes in division we may not be able to equal group or equally share all the objects. Sometimes might be a leftover. The numbers that is the left over in a division, it's called the reminder. The number will always be a smaller than the division. So that all things are important for us, and this must be important. The number that is the left over in division. The number that is the left over in a division, it's called the reminder. It's called the what, dear students? Reminder. So the reminder will always be smaller than the division. The reminder will always be smaller than the division. Okay, so number in each group, it's called a divisor. Here only I am speaking, here only I am telling you here the situation of this example. Okay, number in each group, it's a divisor. Okay, number of group it's called a quotient in this example. Number in all, 30 is divided, 4 threes are 12, and number of the left over there, it's called a remainder. What it's called a remainder, and the remainder is always be a smaller than the divisor. So let's check, our remainder is a smaller than 2 of our divisor. Yes, obviously here 4 is our divisor and remainder is 1, means our remainder is always less than 2 of our divisor. Understood? So now let's check a further example. Second example. Okay, think, how many 8s in 34? How many 8s in 34? How can we decide and how can we check? So how many 8s in 34? So here let's check, dear students, how many 8s in 34? So let's check here, how many 8s in 34? So 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16. We check as like opposite side, dear students. Okay, we check as like the opposite side too. Okay, so 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, 8 fours are 32. Okay, 8 fours are, so see here how many remainder are left. See, after this all things I am telling you, 8 ones are 1, 8 are 8, 2 8s are 16, 3 8s are 24, 4 8s are 32, and 5 8s are 40. So this is more than to 34. 5 8s are 40. 40 is what? More than to 34. So we have to, here we have to take a less than to 34. So take the previous multiplication effect. What, dear students, here we are using? Here we are using the previous multiplication fact. Understood? There are a 4 8s in the 34 and a 2 will be a leftover. There are 4 8s in the 34 and 2 will be a leftover. So 34 divided by 8. So students, in table number 8, 34 will come? No. So we take the less than to 34. 33 will come? No. In table number 8, 33 also not come. So again we take the less than to 33. Okay, so less than to 33 is 32. 32 will come in the table number 8. Yes, but where, dear students, 8 fours are 32. 8 ones are 8, 8 twos are 16, 8 threes are 24, and 8 fours are 32. 8 fours are 32. So 34 minus 30 is 2. So how many left? 2. So answer is 4. Quotient is 4. Remainder left are 2. Left over there is 2. Means quotient is Q is equal to 4, R means remainder is equal to 2. So this is more than to 34, we are not taking. Okay, there are 4 8s. How many 4? See here, there are 4 8s in the 34 and 2 will be a left over. We have to write that word, we have to mention that word. Don't forget to mention that word, dear students. Understood? Now further, checking a division. A last topic of this, today's lecture, and then after we move on to exercise number 6, a question number 1, solve using a short division. Okay, so here let's check checking a division. How can we check our division? Okay, each and every division, you don't forget to write the all things. Q means quotient, R means remainder. So you shortly you write as like that, Q is of a 4, R is a left over there, means a left number are there, we are right. So Q is a quotient and remainder. But we never write in a short, we write a full always. Quotient is equal to 4, remainder is equal to 2. As like that. So first check if the remainder is the smaller than the divisor, dear students. What? First check if the remainder is the smaller than the divisor. You don't forget to checking a remainder is always too smaller than divisor. Understood, dear students, what I am telling you? Okay, so now if the quotient divided by a divisor plus remainder is equal to divided, then the quotient and the remainder that we have two are correct. So see here, what we have past learned, 8 fours are 32. 34 minus 32 is equal to 2. So 48 is 32. 32 plus 2. So how many? 34. It's correct. 32 is correct. Plus 2. 2 is a remainder. Is correct. And 34 is the main answer. So hence it is a correct answer. What, dear students? It is a correct answer. I hope you all are understood, dear students. Now we are move on the further exercise number 6. Today we are going to starting here the exercise number 6, equation number 1, solve using a short division. What, dear students? Exercise number 6, equation number 1, solve using a short division. Okay, so here equation number 1. Equation number 1 is what, dear students? 81 divided by 9. 81 divided by 9. So students, let's check in table number 9. In table number 9, 81 will come or not? Speak the table number 9. Okay, and then you think. So yes, 81 will come in the table number 9. But where, dear students? 9 9s are 81. Where? 9 9s are 81. So quotient what, my dear students? 9. And a remainder 0. Okay, now question number B. 36 divided by 3. 36 divided by 3. So as like we do, 3 1s are 3. Only we are taking the only one digit. 3 1s are 3. 3 1s are 3. 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Then after we bring it down the 6. Okay, so in table number 3, 6 will become, yes, 3 2s are 6. 3 2s are 6. Okay, 6 minus 6. So how many, dear students? 0. 6 minus 6. So how many, my dear students, come? 0. So answer is what? 12. Quotient is what, dear students? 12. And remainder is 0. Remainder is 0. Now we move on the question number C. Let's check here the students' question number C. 28 divided by 4. So in table number 4, 28 will come. Yes, 4 7s are 28. So quotient is 7 and remainder is 0 0. Okay, then after question number D. 66 divided by 6. Okay, so here 6 1s are 6. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Then further we bring in down a 6. Okay, we bring down a 6. See again, 6 1s are 6. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Okay, 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Dear students, I hope you all are understood. Okay, so quotient is what? 11. 66 divided by 6 is equal to 11. Quotient is 11. And remainder is what, dear students? Remainder is 0. Okay, then after the question number E and question number F. So my dear students, let's check here the question number E. Okay, let's check here the question number E. 56 divided by 7. So in table number 7, dear students, table number 7, 56 will come or not? Yes, 56 will come. Obviously, 56 will come in the table number 7. So, 7, 8 is 56. So, 56 minus 56, how many, my dear students? 56 minus 56 is equal to 0, 0. So, means remainder is 0 and quotient is what, dear students? Quotient is 8. Okay, now equation number F. Equation number F is what? 72 divided by 8. 72 divided by 8. Okay, dear students. So, 8 9s are 72. In table number 8, 72 will come? Yes, obviously. 8 9s are 72. So, 72 minus 72 is equal to 0, 0. Okay, dear students. So, quotient is 9 and the remainder is 0. Now, example, question number G. Last two question. Okay. 18 divided by 2. In table number 2, 80 will come. Yes, obviously, dear students, 2 9s are 18. So, 18 minus 18, 0. And quotient is 9. Remainder is 0. Okay. And now, 45 divided by 5. What, dear students? 45 divided by 5. So, in table number 5, 45 will come. Yes, obviously, dear students, 5 9s are 45. 45 minus 45. So, how many left? 0. Okay, so answer is what? 9. Quotient is 9 and remainder is 0. Understood? And this all of this exercise you have to write in your fair book, dear students. I hope you all are understood and enjoying our lecture. Thank you so much, dear students.